Ooh, this hand looks pretty good here. I've got turn two miscalculation, turn three basalt monolith. Maybe not a turn two miscalculation. Maybe a turn two devil's plate or lantern whirls. We'll see. I can certainly see myself casting a devil's plate turn two. If my opponent does nothing, then I'm a lot more likely to, because if my opponent does nothing on turn two, indicates that they can't do anything with three mana, so killing the lantern whirls is basically like a time walk at that point. Well, here's hoping. If our opponent has like a turn 2, 1, 3, like an Oren Viper or something, that'd be weird. Ooh, gamble. Alright, I'm kind of excited. Opponent has a 1 in 5 shot of just straight up discarding the card they gambled for. They don't have channel, so we're not dying this turn. I mean, if you're gambling, you gotta do something pretty powerful to justify it. It's always fun when your opponent casts gamble to also see if the card they discard is what they gambled for. Like, because we don't actually know, but... If my opponent discards Survival of the Fittest, I will assume that that is the card my opponent gambled for. Sun Petal Grove, I assume, is not the card my opponent gambled for. So now if my opponent doesn't do anything, I'd probably just leave up Miscalculation. Because what if my opponent gambled for a 4-drop, or a 3-drop, actually, even? Right, yeah, let's leave up Miscalc, because if my opponent had a 2-drop, it would have gotten cast. I like the position I'm in, unless the card gambled for was like a Vengevine or something, which would be annoying. I think I'm in okay shape. Plus, now I can cast Basalt Monolith into Burning of Xin Yi if I need to. You know, I should have just taken Inferno Titan. That was ridiculous. Well, I don't know. I mean, I guess against a lot of the same decks, Inferno Titan is just a better version, but having the second Wildfire is pretty nice with like multiple artifact sources, so it is definitely better against Doomblades. Alright. Hope you weren't gambling for Experiment 1. Countryside Crusher, that is a good candidate. Alright, well, I'm going to counter that. And at this point, I'm over Devils playing the Elf. I think I would rather just play Basalt Monolith, and if I have to cast Burning, then I will do that. And let's see. Ooh, or Frost Titan. I'm going to play the Mountain. This way, if I have to cast Burning of Xin Yi, then I don't need to play a fourth land, so I don't lose a fourth land. Like, if my opponent plays a fourth land, then plays a creature that dies to Burning of Xin Yi, I will be very tempted to do that, to kill everything. Chain Lightning me. Okay, this deck should not be playing Gamble, just so we're clear. Alright, I think I'm going to put my opponent down to no permanence. Could do that. But then I only have one permanent. You know what? Let's just play Consecrated Sphinx. If I play Consecrated Sphinx, and then... it lives, then I probably just win the game straight up. And there aren't very many cards my opponent can use to kill Consecrated Sphinx. I could have played Frost Titan and tapped down Experiment 1, but I'd rather draw two cards a turn. Because then next turn I can play Glenelinda Archmage, then, or maybe even next turn if I draw some lands, yeah, I can just cast, or I can just like maybe untap Basalt Monolith and then cast a Burning of Xin Yi and then just straight up be unbeatable here. Getting smashed. My opponent is offering the trade of Experiment 1 plus a burn spell for Consecrated Sphinx. Yeah, I suppose I can take that. I don't love it, but my hand is so stacked that if that's what's happening, that's what's happening. I think I would rather do that than go to 8 and then, I don't know, somehow get burned out. Seems pretty unlikely either way. But I think this is reasonable. Does my opponent have like a Brimstone Volley? Unfortunately, Brimstone Volley doesn't get to trample over on me. One could have a Fire Blast, that would be pretty funny. Next turn, I might just Devils play the Llanowar Elf and untap Basalt Monolith. That could be sweet. Alright, yeah, Brimstone Volley was, in fact, not the uber combo my opponent wanted. See, I'm glad I didn't go to 8 against a Brimstone Volley. That's 5 points of burn already, and then, you know, a random Lightning Bolt, and then later, and we're dead. Might as well rank up the Elf. Alright, so now, let's Devils play that. Get my opponent Rancor back, and then I'm going to play Forest so I can untap Basalt Monolith so I can cast anything I want. Could be Burning or Wildfire, could be Frost Titan, could be Glenelinda Archmage, but I think that's less likely than just casting Frost Titan. I think this is the most likely play. My opponent plays one good creature, I just Frost Titan it, and then get to Wildfire, hopefully fairly soon thereafter. And when you Wildfire with a Frost Titan out, you usually win the game. Ooh, Plateau. What if my opponent has Armageddon? Johnny Vengeance. All right, that's a good card, but it's not the card that's gonna win my opponent the game here. I guess you lock down Mountain is the one that makes the most sense to me. Or I guess you have Maya Coast actually is the second colored source of multiple colors, so that's probably for the best. All right, so I can't counter or can't cast Frost Titan, so let's just play Glenlyndra Archmage, leaving up 3 mana because I can just untap Basalt Monolith later. And then might as well play Thawing Glaciers here. And pass the turn. Still feeling pretty good about this. Opponent has Rancor plus 1 card in hand. I can deal with almost any kind of threat, and eventually I'm going to get to cast this Frost Titan followed by this Wildfire. Also, Thawing Glaciers is a card that makes sense to lock down here, so that does give me the opportunity to cast Frost Titan. Untap that. Attack a Johnny, I think. Even though a Johnny is going to get killed by Frost Titan next turn, I think it's still what I want to do. All right, play Frost Titan. All right, is that too much mana? That is too much mana. All right, Frost Titan, I can still. I think I'm actually tapping down. No, I'm going to tap down Plateau. I'm not tapping down Forest, even though my opponent probably has more green cards in the deck. I'm tapping down Plateau because most of the cards that beat me, like Path to Exile or something, are white. Whereas, yeah, a card like Abyssinian Pilgrim is not going to beat me here. All right, locking down the Glenlyndra Archmage. Yeah, that's acceptable. Might as well get a Mountain and untap Basalt Monolith here. Right now I have the full lock since Glenlyndra Archmage is active. Let's attack a Johnny and tap down Abyssinian Pilgrim. And then kill a Johnny and I think just pass the turn. I don't really want a Wildfire. I could just win the game by Wildfiring, but I think I'm going to win the game anyway. And I don't really want to show my opponent Wildfire because that's actually a card you need to play around. I still have Devil's Play in my graveyard too. All right, Mog War Marshal or Fathom Seer. What's the better blocker against random crappy dudes? I guess Fathom Seer because it can also turn face up and do something awesome. Then I can cut Mystic Snake, which I actually think is just good for me. Because then I get to cut some painful lands. And so I'm cutting red, red, blue, green. So I can probably just add two of each. Oop. And this makes my mana better as well. Still like the 19 land. Though actually, now that I want to put in Mog War Marshal as well, maybe I can just go to 18 land now and cut a red here because I have shackles my deck. Let's see. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8 red plus a Thawing Glaciers, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 12 blue. That is closer to right than not. So there's also negate. Do I want negate? Ooh, actually, what if I side in Emrakul and Show and Tell? Is that a good plan? Because Show and Telling in a Consecrated Sphinx or a Frost Titan actually seems fine against my opponent's all 1, 2, and 3 drops. So I have 3 good targets, plus maybe an Aetherling to Show and Tell in. Yeah, this actually seems good. And then you might as well put the Emrakul in for Mizzen purposes. If you're going to put in Show and Tell, you got to put in Emrakul. I do need to cut a card now. Maybe I do cut the Mog War Marshal. Yeah, why play Mog War Marshal when you can just play Show and Tell?